you know, and just drive your knees up high. Now, if this is too challenging, then, you know, if you're slower in this exercise, that's fine, as long as it feels super intense for you. You can also, if the high knees are really too much for you, you can try this or feet together. But if you really want to kick your butt, go for the high knees. So we're doing high knees after each exercise. So we're starting with high knees, then you're gonna move on to this exercise, which is, you're gonna need dumbbells. I'm using 10-pound dumbbells, and you're gonna do a squat. So your knees and toes are pointing slightly outwards. You're gonna push your hips back, keep your back straight, abs tight. Go with your butt below your knees. And now as you stand up, you're gonna press up the dumbbells. So it's like a one fluid movement. You don't just stand up and then press up. Just try to do it in one flow. So you're gonna squat down and then up and press up. And just again, make sure that you're not rounding your back when you're doing the squat. Do not round your back like this. Make sure that your back stays flat, you know, and you're pushing your hips really far back. And then you push, try to push off of your heels. And keep a good form. So after this exercise, you're gonna move on again to the high knees with the jump rope. And the second exercise is dumbbell rows. So you're gonna, again, grab your dumbbells. And now you're gonna bend forward like this. Keep your back straight. And you're gonna do two rows. One and two. Then go on the ground. Put the dumbbells on the ground. Your hands right directly underneath your shoulders. Kick back into the plank. And now dig the toes into the ground so that your hips don't move like this. And make a row, another row. And then back up and keep going. Two rows like this, and then two rows on the ground. When you're in the plank, make sure that your hips do not drop down, because when your hips drop down when you're in the plank, it's really hard on your lower back, and you don't want to injure or hurt in any ways your lower back. So keep your body either in one straight line, which is amazing for your abs, and if you feel like you don't have enough strength, that your hips might drop down, then rather push your hips a little bit up just to protect your lower back. And that's it. So after this exercise, you're gonna move on again to the high knees. And after that, you're gonna need only one dumbbell. And you're gonna hold it like this with both hands. And start in the lunge position with your knee pointing straight forward. Do not buckle the knee in. Keep it straight. Abs tight, chest up, shoulders back and down. Now you're gonna jump, switch legs. And you're gonna twist to the side. So across the front knee and down and then up. Jump, switch legs and twist to the side and up. And keep going. Push really hard. Try to do as many reps as you can during the 25-second interval. Then you're gonna put the dumbbell down. High knees again. And the last exercise is gonna be one leg push-up with a toe touch. So you're gonna get into the plank. And now you're gonna go with your one foot, with the left foot across your body. And you're gonna touch the left foot with your right hand. Do not put the leg down, because you wanna do the push-up immediately. So again, you're in the plank, toe touch, and one leg push-up. Super challenging exercise, definitely for those of you who are already advanced. If you cannot do a regular push-up even, then this exercise, you know, does not apply to you. Then you have to do a push-up off of your knees. But don't worry about it, you're gonna get there. So, if you cannot do even a regular push-up like this, then go on your knees and do push-up off of your knees. But you can still do the toe touch at least. So, do a toe touch, then go on your knees and do the push-up. And that's it. So, that was one round. You're gonna go through this one more time and then you're done, you know. So it's a really dynamic workout. You're not gonna have time even to think. You're gonna just go from exercise to exercise. It's gonna fly, the time is gonna fly so fast, you know, so you won't even realize, and it's gonna be over. So no excuses right now. If you don't have time, you still have time. You have time, you have 8 minutes. You know, anyone has that kind of time. So don't make any excuses, do this workout and let me know how you did. And on Thursday, I'm gonna post this workout in a real time. So you're gonna see my real effort and my real sweat doing this workout. And that's it. So check out my website, zuzkalaj.com, because I'm gonna have the workout breakdown there in a written form as well for you. And on Thursday, there's gonna be the workout. And also, I would like to remind you that I'm doing my ZCAT Power Cardio program. Besides doing once a week my ZWOW, I started doing my ZCAT Power Cardio, and I'm updating you with my results on a daily basis and how I'm doing. So it's a coaching program for you. You can jump on the wagon with me and do the program with me if you want. And also diet, really important thing. So I'm always like to remind you about diet. You have to pay attention to what you eat, how much do you eat and stuff like that. So I have all of that information on my website, zuzkalaj.com as well. So check it out, and that's it. So have a great day and I will see you guys tomorrow. Ciao.
Hi, I'm Zuzka and this is my new DVD cardio series.
It's supposed to be super intense workout and you feel like you have no strength left.
I don't spend hours working out at the gym. What I do are short but high intensity body shaping workouts. I have taken my most effective moves and workouts and created DVD cardio series that is going to change your body.
This is workout number 4. We're doing Tabata training. 20 seconds of maximum effort, 10 seconds rest, and there are 5 exercises in this workout. Let's do this.
You are going to be fitter, stronger, and thinner, but most importantly, you're going to love the way you look. The Power Cardio DVD series comes with 3 DVDs and 30-day fold-out calendar that will guide you day by day to get you into the best shape ever.
So now we're gonna do our cool down and stretching. That's what you should do after each one of your workouts. Now you're gonna do a knee tuck. So the top leg is gonna do knee tuck. You're gonna try to bring your knee towards your elbow and then back down, bring your hips back down on the ground and repeat. So up, knee tuck, and down. Now, if you're a beginner, then just try to work on doing this hip lift. So just try to work on getting into the side plank. So if you're a beginner and you cannot do the knee tuck, because that's really, it's a really challenging exercise, then try to at least bring your hips up into the side plank. So then we're gonna switch sides and do the same thing. And there are 2 other exercises. So one of them is walk out burpee with one leg only. So this one leg's gonna be in the air the entire time. And you're gonna squat down on one leg, put your hands on the ground. Now you're gonna walk out into the plank. Here, keep your body in one straight line. Bring your body down and then push up and walk your way back and jump up on one leg. It's a great exercise. agility, balance, strength, you're gonna be improving everything with this exercise. So now if you're a beginner, then you don't want to do it on one leg, do it on both legs. So you're gonna walk out again here. If you're too weak to do, or if you're not too weak, but if you're not too strong to do regular push-up, then go on your knees and do the push-up off of your knees like this. You can also modify the push-up by bringing your hips a little bit up. It might help you, and bend your elbows at least slightly. And then walk your way up and jump up. And that's it. So this is one leg walkout burpee. The last exercise, the third exercise that we're doing in this workout, is side jump lunge with the dumbbells. I'm using 8-pound dumbbells, and let me tell you, this exercise is amazing for your legs, especially for your butt, and it's an amazing cardio. If you add the weights to it, I was surprised how hard this exercise was. So you're gonna start in a side lunge. So this leg is bent. You're gonna push your hips back, keep your back straight, and try to get the knee into 90 degree angle. So really push your hips back, try to get the thigh parallel to the ground, and you're gonna be reaching with the opposite arm towards your foot. Now we're gonna power up. You're gonna switch legs again, reach towards the foot with the dumbbell, and make sure that the other leg is fully extended. So jump and switch like this. Common mistake is round back. You don't want to be rounding your back. You want to keep your back straight. Really think about keeping your back straight and abs tight, pushing your hips back. And that's it. And try to keep up the pace. Now, if you're a beginner again, and it's hard for you already this exercise, then forget about the weight. Try to do it with just your own body weight. And that's it. So practice these exercises at home. Let me know if you have any questions. Remember, we're doing this workout together on Thursday. Also, don't forget to visit my website, zuzkalight.com, because all of the Z-Wows are there. We have already 45 workouts. This week we're adding another one. There are nutrition tips that I have for you guys in my Z-blog. So visit the site, leave me a comment there, and I'll see you on Thursday with Z-Wow 46. Ciao. It was super fast, but really, really intense.